So like every song you've probably heard for like the last 5 years, I made in this room at one point with my feet in this big massager. All right, guys, get over here. This is the house, studio, live, work, whatever it is. I like plants. I have a little jungle over here. The upkeep is real. You know, it can be very hard to maintain this. I have a green thumb, but sometimes they get upset and just die. They die. It's the circle of life. Things die. All right, now we're in my studio. This is where everything fucking goes down. You guys want a little tour? It's weird to be on this side of the camera, literally. I'm usually like a behind the scenes type of guy, and I don't know, I decided to make an album many years later in my career, but I hope you guys like it. This is one of my favorites because it's like, it's actually crazy because I usually only use vintage gear, but this one's like a remake of an old Mellotron. And for some reason I love it because like all these always crap out and like I gotta redo them and get them fixed like every fucking second. The thing I hate the most is when any of my music sounds like anyone else. So what I do is I add all these little pedals and stuff to make it sound even weirder. So it's like. I was on the road with Ed Sheeran and we were finishing the last album, Divide, and I did that album with them. And we were watching the Jimmy Iovine, Dr. Dre documentary. And it was before one of his shows, we're backstage. We watched three of them in a row. It took 3 hours. So we're watching it and we finish. And he literally stands up and he's like, man, what the fuck are we even doing with our lives? And I was like, what the fuck are we doing with our lives? And he's like, all right, man, I'm gonna go out and play this show. And I was like, okay, cool. And he literally went out and played for a stadium. And I'm sitting there in the backstage and I'm like, what the fuck are we doing with our lives? And I was like, just like going around in my head. And then I was just thinking about like how Dr. Dre did it and how he put out that album and how, and then he did his record label. And it's a little bit different, much different than my career. But I was like, man, I should probably like try to make songs and put them out by the way that, you know, technology is and the landscape is. And you don't really have to be an artist. Like you don't have to like go out and like play shows and tour the world. And I hate flying, so that would be very difficult for me. And I just decided, I was like, man, I'm gonna try it. And I made some songs and we actually started a song like the next day that became East Side. The only thing I use is this leg massager right here. It's pretty much the only thing I use in the studio. I don't really, oh man, it's got a little heat sensor and ugh. Oh boy. So like every song you've probably heard for like the last 5 years, I made in this room at one point with my feet in this big massager. When we first started East Side, we were in Philadelphia. And it just kind of started as this demo thing. And I had in the back of my mind that I wanted to make a album, but I wasn't sure. And there was just this little demo. And then one day I was with Halsey and we're just chilling. We were working on another song for her album at the time. And I was like, oh my God, I have this little idea. Do you want to mess with it? And like, before I knew it, like she's on it. Then I was randomly talking to Khalid and I was like, hey, I always wanted to do a song with you. And he was like, yeah, me too. And I was like, I don't really have that many songs, but I have this song that like I'm working on for my record. Do you want to try something? And he was in Denmark and he was like, yeah, sure. And he like tried a little idea on it. Then he came to LA and we finished it. And like, it was like so organic and it just kind of happened out of nowhere. And I had no fucking idea it was gonna be as big as it wound up being. Over here, we have some weed.
Yeah.
Here's some weed. Okay, so weed's not legal in Australia, but here it's legal. So I'm a law-abiding citizen. But no, weed, I don't know. I smoke weed. I can't smoke when I work though. I can never smoke weed when I work. And for, I smoke and I just want to eat everything, or I get so paranoid that I want to like go to bed immediately. So I found you with Calvin Harris is an interesting one. Cause like for years and years, I've been trying to work with Calvin, and we were just like friends, and like we had done like a little bit of stuff, and we were just like, we were like more like online friends. And then like one day I was like, hey man, let me come over. And we like, I like came over, we started working on music. I was like, I want you to sing. Why aren't you singing? Like you haven't sang in so long. And he's like, man, I'm over singing. And I was like, dude, you have to sing. It's my favorite thing in the world. It's like that nostalgia. It's like, it's amazing. You have to do it. And he was like, oh, I don't want to. And then we started like digging through all these old demos he made. And there was this like, these like two that were like in parts, and it was I Found You, and it like, we like just started working on it, and he was so not into it. And I like just kept begging him, and I was like, oh, please, please. And we like, I was like, we don't have to do anything with him. We just like kept on working on it. And then like eventually he was like, yeah, it's pretty good. Like, I guess I like it. And then like, it just, we finished it. And it's like, I don't know, for me, it just has that feeling of like that old Calvin where you're just like, oh my God, like I've heard this song, but I haven't heard this song, and like I immediately am happy and want to just like dance around. I feel like every artist stands in front of this thing and they're just like, and you just have to like, you're Time Magazine.